Hey everyone, this is Manly Badass Hero, and welcome back to Danganronpa. Previously in Danganronpa, we were introduced to our cast, but then we realized that a good portion of them are probably gonna die off. You must kill someone if you want to leave. My mind froze, and my breath caught in my throat as I thought about that. I could feel a paralyzing fear slowly making its way through my body, dominating every last nerve. The air hung heavy on me, pressing down like a weight around my neck. It took everything I had just to endure that weight. Not really, because nothing's actually happening. To survive daily life. But for as heavy as the air felt, all it took to pierce it was her sharp words.
And?
So, what are you going to do now?
Hey.
Just stand around glaring at each other. Her pointed comment was directed at everyone in the room. It helped pull us all back to reality. Right. She's right.
Listen to me!
Sometimes, even if you're nervous or afraid, you just have to step forward. To forget such a simple fact, I can't forgive myself. I'm so ashamed.
You hear me?
Please, someone hit me. I can't forgive myself. Someone hit me. Punish me. Boy, that's a developing kink. Jesus, if you have time to yell about it, you have time to do something about it.
However...
Perhaps. But what is the mission exactly?
Stupid.
Idiot. Look for a way out, duh.
What the...
And we totally need to find whoever was controlling that stupid bear, and beat the hell out of him. But before we do all that, maybe we should take a look at the handbook. It's probably best to check out the school regulations Monokuma mentioned before doing anything else.
This is fine.
True. If we stumble around with no clue what the rules are, something like that might happen again. Shit.
Alright. So
fine.
Then
let's hurry up and check out the stupid rules already. After turning on my e-handbook, the first thing that appeared was my name. So just like Monokuma said, the owner's name showed up front and center. Then, from the main menu that popped up, I selected the school regulations icon. Let's see, itemized list appeared on screen, and we'll see. School regulations, students may only sign within the school. In other words, the rules being imposed on us all. Students may reside only within the school. 2. Nighttime is from 10 to 7. It's 10 PM to 7 AM. Some areas are off limits at night, so please exercise caution. I'm assuming you blow up if you go in those areas. Sleeping anywhere other than the dormitory will be seen sleeping in class, and punished accordingly. With minimal restrictions, you are free to explore Hope's Peak Academy at your discretion. Violence against Headmaster Monokuma is strictly prohibited, as is destruction of surveillance cameras. Anyone who kills a fellow student and becomes blackened will graduate unless they are discovered. Additional school regulations may be added as necessary. So that's where the Phoenix Wright part comes in. Feeling a slight dizziness, I raised my face up from the screen. As I looked around, I saw the same stormy expression on everyone's faces.
Stop fucking around!
This is bullshit! What the hell kind of rules are these? I'm not gonna let them control me. Well then, why don't you wander around the school without a care in the world, and see what happens? Personally, I would love to see what happens when someone breaks one of the rules.
However...
They die. But if he got punished, like what we saw before, I don't think it'll be a respawn waiting for him. This is not a video game, this is a visual novel.
Yo.
Ever since I was a kid, I grew with my older brother pounding this into my head. When a man makes a promise, he has to keep it, even if it kills him.
And...
so what?
What?
I've made a ton of promises that I still have to keep. That's so what.
Piece of shit!
So I can't afford to die in here. None of that made much sense to me. But you are saying you will follow the regulations. Is that it?
That's true.
Well, yeah. I guess you're right. I have a question. For regulation number 6, what do you think it means exactly? Kill someone and don't get caught. Anyone who kills a fellow student and becomes blackened will graduate unless they are discovered. You're talking about the second half, right? Where it says unless they are discovered. I was wondering about that myself. It's saying that if you want to graduate, you have to kill someone without anyone finding out it was you. But why? Why do we have to do that? I don't see any reason to worry about it. Just worry about following the rules that they've been explained to us.
Such ignorance.
Frankly, I don't want to hear anything from someone who waits for others to decide what to do for them. Don't jab at me.
Give me a break.
Ooh, foreshadowing. More like a full-on stab. Well, for now, let's forget all that silly junk about murderers or whatever.
Okay.
Now that we know the rules, let's start exploring the school. Vrew, we need to find out where exactly we are. Is there any way out? What about food and supplies?
You understand?
There are tons of questions we need to answer.
Let's do it!
Damn straight. Okay, then let's all start looking around. I'll be going alone, because I'm too cool.
What?
What? Why? That's a pretty stupid idea, don't you think? Someone here might already have started thinking about murdering one of us. Are you saying we should stand around with them in our midst and make it that much easier for them?
Hold on a second.
Wait, hold on a second. That would never... of anything, if you travel in groups, it's wolf-sheep puzzle. So... less likely to happen. Don't bother saying it couldn't happen. You can't deny the possibility. That's why you all seized up with fear when that graduation rule was made clear to you. Am I wrong? But... So I'm simply acting in accordance with what I think is best for me.
Just hold on.
Hold on. Like hell I'm gonna let you run off and do whatever you want.
What?
Out of my way, Plankton.
What?
The fuck that's supposed to mean?
Such ignorance.
One tiny bit of plankton, drifting across the sea. So minuscule, so insignificant, they couldn't possibly have any kind of influence on the boundless ocean.
You're fucking dead.
I'm gonna kick your ass. Stop it. We shouldn't fight.
What?
The fuck you just say? You some kind of goody-goody little bitch?
You wanna throw down?
Who do you think you are, talking to me like that? You think you're my fucking dad or something? I'm gonna friend you with these one-liners. No, I wasn't...
You son of a bitch!
I only have 5 recorded lines of dialogue, but I hope it's intimidating. He punched me, and I flew back in a heap. It was like something straight out of a comic book. I didn't even see the punch coming. It was just suddenly right there in my face. One second, I was standing there. The next, I was soaring through the air. Now that I think about it, maybe I'd kind of forgotten. The kind of people I'd been trapped here with. My common sense had just stopped functioning. Being around all these ultimates had blown my fuses. So, I guess I shouldn't be surprised it led to something as absurd as this. But I just... lost track of that sense of reality. That was my last thought as my consciousness started to fade. Before it finally cut out completely. And when I finally opened my eyes again, what I saw was... oh god, is someone dead? Already? BGM. Where am I? As if it had become part of my daily routine. I woke up in yet another room I'd never seen before. Okay, so... where am I now? Finally, I can actually manually save. You have to get through a 2-hour prologue before you can manually save. Alright, first thing... key. This must be the key to the room. My name's written on the keychain. Which means it must be mine, right? I better hang on to it for now. It's some kind of lint roller. I guess we're supposed to clean up after ourselves. No, pick it up. We need to clean this lint off ourselves. Cleanse the sin. It's a notepad. I guess the school must have given one to each of us. Check the drawers. It looks like there's something in the drawer. It's a toolkit. Take that toolkit. It must be brand new. It's still in the shrink wrap. I don't really need it right now, so I'll just leave it here. Which frustrates me, but you know, whatever. No plates. Security camera. A surveillance camera. I hate the idea that someone might be watching me right now. Check the bed. There doesn't seem to be anything particularly strange about the bed. Video camera. Note on the wall. Piece of paper hanging up on the wall which says, announcement from Headmaster Monokuma. Each room's lock has been designed to completely protect against tampering or lockpicking. This is a clue. Remaking an individual room key is quite troublesome, so please make sure not to lose yours. The room comes furnished with a shower, but please note that the water is turned off at nighttime. Also, the bathrooms are in the girls' room, include the lock of their own. Finally, we prepared a small gift for each of you. For the girls, a sewing kit. For the boys, a toolkit. The sewing kit includes a map of the body's vital organs. One stab will do the job, girls. For the boys, we believe a strong blow to the head with any of the tools should be ample. Don't think, just feel, and be tanishin. I crumpled up the sheet of paper and threw it in the trash. Nice. Okay, so... we should remember some of these clues here. The locks cannot be picked or anything. The water goes off at night. And I feel like there was going to be something in one of the trials where it's going to be like, I was just taking a shower! And it's like, no, the water turns off at night. Objection. Huh? It's not opening. I guess it's locked. Well, let's leave. So some of the rooms have locks, huh? I think I'm starting to understand. This room must be... a prison. This is my assigned dorm room. Someone must have carried me here after I fell unconscious. So that answers to that question. The next question is... what's everyone else up to right now? There's only one way to find out. That's to get out of here. Bathroom is still locked on me. Yes. I rushed out of the room to meet up with all the others. But there was someone waiting for me there. It was like something out of an old TV show. Ah! Who? I see what you mean by an old TV show.
Oh, Sayaka? Sorry. Are you okay?
I'm fine. I hope you're okay. Sorry about that.
Where's your toast? She had an embarrassed smile on her face. I stood up slowly. So much for having all the provisions in this place. Are you okay, Sayaka? Are you hurt? You make it sound worse than it is. I'm completely fine. I know how I look, but I've actually built some pretty good muscle jumping up and down on stage. Yeah, it's actually true. That's good then. But are you okay? You know, from when Mondo hit you. That's true. I got knocked out right there in front of everyone. I guess I revealed my lack of cool right from the beginning.
Makoto.
Oh, I'm fine. Nothing wrong here.
That's good.
I was kind of worried. Thanks. You too, but anyway, what are you doing here? Actually, I came to get you. You came to get me?
Listen.
Well, if you really are feeling better, I was hoping you'd come to the dining hall. The dining hall?
You see.
After you got knocked out, everyone decided to go and do their own thing. We decided to be more effective if we split up to investigate, so that we'd get picked off when they win. So we agreed to go to get together later on and talk about what we each find out. So does that mean it's almost time to get back together? If that's what's going on, then of course I'll go with you.
That's good.
Good. I'll go on ahead and meet you at the dining hall then. So let's see, now... here's how the rooms are laid out. So... Kyoko. We're on the second floor, there's bathrooms up over here. I don't know if there's any use to going inside of them. There's shops. I guess there's really no use to go into the other areas. If they're not like opened up. Ooh, a bath. This must be the dormitory dining hall. It looks pretty clean, so that's good. Onokuma has high standards for cleanliness. He's a good worker program. I guess that's not really important right now, with us being prisoners here and all. Is that a window leading to the outside? Yeah, that's true. Nobody was there waiting for us. We don't really have much choice. I guess we should just wait here for now. Okay, let's just wait here. Huh? You heard that?
Like I said, I'm psychic.
You really are psychic, aren't you? Oh no, you're screwing with me. Come on, I'm just kidding. Seriously, I just have amazing intuition. Is it really just intuition? It's kind of a sudden, but I know here comes a tutorial. Right now, I'd like to talk about reactions. You're gonna be talking to Sayaka, right? But while you're talking to her, some purple words are gonna appear. By the way, I have this on mean difficulty. On both settings. Purple words, go right-click, reaction mode. Review whatever you talked about to look for more info. Action. Yeah, that's definitely a window to the out. No, it could be like cement, like an indoor garden. Yeah, because I see like walls going up.
Hey,
by the way, Makoto? Huh? What is it? Well, it's just... I know this is kind of continuing the self-introduction thing. Continuing our self-introductions? We kinda got cut off before, but I had a question I wanted to ask you. Sayaka wants to ask me something. I wonder what it is. Now I'm really curious.
Hey,
this one. What did you want to ask me? Mokoto, did you happen to go to the Blackroot Junior High? Were you maybe in class too? Ooh, maybe we're childhood friends. Yeah, actually I was. I knew it. I went there too. I was in class 4 though. Do you remember me? She's too precious for this world. Do I remember? Even back in middle school, she was a celebrity with all kinds of ultimates surrounding her. How could I forget? Almost as surprising as her question was, that she remembered me. We never even talked to each other, but somehow she still knew who I was.
Hey,
because I have Protag syndrome and she recognized this by where I sat in the class. Hey, are you okay? Oh yeah, I'm just surprised, is all. I wouldn't have thought you'd remember me. We went to the same school for 3 years. Of course I remember. Well, that's true. But there were a lot of students in our grade, right? Plus, I've never been the type of person to ever really stand out. I'm average at everything, and all my hobbies are totally normal. Even normal would call me boring. What are you talking about? You're so strange. So strange that... She started giggling even louder. That somehow mysterious smile of hers made my heart grow calmer. Doki's resigning. Kokoro, weakening. Her smile was the nicest smile I'd ever seen.
That's good.
Anyway, I'm really glad that I know somebody here. Talking to you has made me feel a lot better about all this. You're amazing, Makoto.
Makoto.
No, I'm really not. I'm nothing at all compared to you ultimates. Don't worry, you'll be an Avenger. But you're the one that helped me find my courage again. Not any of those ultimate students. Thank you for saying that.
Okay.
And to thank you for helping me out, I'm going to become your ultimate assistant. Huh? My assistant? Yep, I'm your assistant now. I'm going to help you out as much as I can. So let's get out of here together. When she says things like that, it just gets me pumped up! Which is nice, but still. Everyone else is still late. Besides that, I don't even know what time it is right now. There must be a clock around here somewhere. So, there's no hands. Okay. 7 o'clock at night, we gotta go back! You were unconscious for a pretty long time. I see. Without being able to look out a window, I've lost all sense of time. If I have to stay in this place for too long, I might just go crazy.
Hey,
I can't believe no one's here yet, but I'm sure they'll start showing up soon. Almost like he timed it. Taka threw open the dining hall doors right as Sayaka said that.
Hey!
Ah, Makoto, Sayaka. So you two got here first, huh?
How unfortunate.
Too bad. I was sure I'd beat everyone here. Just slacking eyebrows. I guess that means I just don't have enough fighting spirit yet.
Got it.
Well, I won't give up. Next time, I swear I'll win no matter what it takes. Justice shall always prevail. That's a bit much, don't you think? And soon after that, everyone else came strolling in one after another. After a few minutes, everyone had gathered in the dining hall.
Okay, it looks like everyone's here. Time to start the meeting. Let's all go around and share what we found out during our respective investigations. The sooner we find out what's going on, the sooner we get out of here.
Hold on a sec.
What are you talking about?
And what about... what's her name? You know, the silver-haired girl. Oh yeah. Kyoko. What about her? She's not here. Because she knows what's up, that's what. I took another look around the dining hall. Sure enough, she was nowhere to be seen. I wonder where she went. Has anyone seen her? But everyone just shook their heads.
Huh?
Wait, so nobody's seen her? Why hasn't Kyoko shown up yet? Could it be because...
Yes, indeed!
Okay, Monokuma. Is it possible? Was she really... No, I'm just overthinking things. Darn it, Kyoko. You're really going to be late like this on the first day of school. Not only is she late, she didn't tell anyone she would be late. The most unbecoming personality trait.
Come on.
You're being a real jackass right now. You know that? Well, what do you want me to do? Punctuality is everything.
You hear me?
Now then, I declare that the first session of the Hope's Peak Academy briefing meetings has begun. Makoto, actually, first of all, I've talked enough. Maybe we should listen to what everyone else has to say. Okay, let's do that. You know? Huh? What's up? I feel like I really have become your personal assistant. Don't you agree? I may not be the best assistant in the world, but I'll give it everything I've got. Too precious for this cast. Death flagged up the butt. No, you've already done so much as my assistant. If I had to, like, say who I think's gonna die, I think you're gonna die. I think the baseball guy might be dead, and the biker guy I think is pretty death flagged. Not sure who else yet, but... I actually wouldn't be surprised if at least 80% of the cast bites the bullet. So if you throw a dart, you're probably gonna catch something. See, I think you're gonna live. You're definitely gonna live. I feel bad for anyone who attacks you, to be honest. Pink. Okay, since you're so in the dark about all this, let me lay out what's been going on. Everyone's been up to investigate different parts of the building, but...
You see?
I wanted to try and find some clue as to who's responsible for imprisoning us here. But unfortunately, I made no such discoveries. That's all for me. Really? That's it? If I uncovered anything, naturally I would have more to say. But I didn't. So I don't. Right, understood.
You see?
I spent some time looking around the dormitory and...
Listen to me!
There I made the discovery of the century. I found that there was exactly one room for each person, okay? Well, yeah, I figured that out before anything else.
Yeah.
Each door already has a nameplate on it, so I guess all the rooms have been assigned already. And each room key is attached to a keychain with the owner's name, precision etched onto it. Which confirms that the room I was in earlier is, in fact, my room.
And plus.
And Chihiro and I found out that all the rooms are totally soundproof. Your next door neighbor could scream their lungs out, and you wouldn't hear a thing. Well, each room also had a private bathroom, which could also lock, just for the girls. But it looked like there was only locks on the bathrooms in the girls' dorms. Huh? But when I checked my bathroom door before, it definitely seemed like it was locked. That's weird. I should double check that later.
Hey, come on!
I just mean that you're considered one of the girls, man. I actually think someone might lock themselves in there, like a missing person. Okay, so they got a bunch of rooms ready for us. They're assuming we're gonna be here a while.
Quiet down and listen!
Well, better to have than have not. At least we don't have to worry about surviving like wild animals. That can't be all you have to report, can it, Mr. Honor Student?
Got it!
That's all for my report. Let's move on to whoever's next.
You see.
Okay. We went all up and down the school, double checking the windows and all the hallways and glasses. We wanted to see if we could get any of those metal plates to come off. What happened was... Nothing. Not a damn thing. We couldn't get a single one to budge even a little bit.
What should I do?
There wasn't any hope of escape anywhere. The question is, how do they bring the food in here? Maybe there's an escape route there. The school really has been totally cut off.
This is bad.
This sucks.
Bad, 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 bad!
What the hell are we gonna do?
Hey, come on!
Goddamn, calm down. You're starting to make me nervous. It's kind of weird how I have to click back into you and like...
You see?
Individually click through all these. We thought maybe we could find some way to communicate with the outside, so we went looking all over.
Sorry.
But we didn't find a thing. Sorry.
Yo.
I went back to the main hall, thinking maybe we could do something about that giant hunk of metal after knocking me out.
What?
Being with Sakura and me both, they wouldn't budge. We hit with desks and chairs, but nothing.
Shit.
It was hard as... like metal.
Yes,
well,
indeed.
Metal plates. Exactly, metal plates are hard as metal. Anyway, if we're gonna get out of here, it's not gonna be through there. I feel like I could just cry, but no. I have to hold it in. I have to manage my hydration.
So then.
I shall tell you what happened next. It has nothing to do with communicating with the outside world, but it's still worth worrying about. In both the school and dorm areas, there was a set of stairs leading up to another roof.
But
there was gates there. And we couldn't find any way to open them, so we couldn't check it out. In other words, at this point we are only able to search the first floor.
However,
we can further assume that there is potentially something above the second floor as well. And if that's the case, there's at least a chance it may lead to a way out. Good. That's progress.
You see?
If I'm being honest, I can't quite say we acted as one. Rather, we did nothing as one. We spent the entire time in the gym.
Most unfortunate.
Honestly, we are not exactly the types to go running around the school like a gang of junior detectives.
What the hell's wrong with you?
What the hell are you thinking? Just sitting around the gym the whole time? Well, it's not like any of you invited me along. Nobody said a, hey, come with us. Take initiative. Don't be so entitled. I blame you for leaving me out. It's your fault.
What the?
If you wanted to go with someone, you should have just said something. Forget it. Like I'd want to go anywhere with a dirty slut like you.
Huh?
Wow. Your mind is fit as your body. You make me sick to my stomach.
Are you for real?
I don't even know how to react. How can you say something so awful to someone you just met?
Hey, come on!
Alright guys, come everybody good, just calm down, okay? All this stress is bad for your skin, you know?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. It sounds like you two are so close now, you're fighting like sisters.
That doesn't work that way. That's a really bad family.
I don't think that's what's going on, Sayaka.
Hey,
So that's what they have to say, huh? Then I guess I'm the only one left. I went and had a look around the dining hall. I found a fridge in the back of the kitchen, and it was overflowing with all kinds of stuff.
That's good.
I guess we don't have to worry about food, at least.
What?
Sure, for now. But even with all that, there are 15 of us. How long can the food last? You can just eat sesame seeds or something. Or we can start cannibalizing each other. What am I? A parakeet? I don't think we have to worry about it. All the food gets restocked automatically each day, but how? At least, that's what Monokuma said.
Huh?
You saw him?
Okay.
Yeah. He came out of nowhere while I was checking the fridge, told me that, then disappeared again. He was so fast. I can't believe someone could have been moving around with a remote control.
That's...
I think you might be Death Flag too. I don't know, everyone's just gonna die. You know, you just, like I said, you just throw a dart, lands on someone, yep. A weaponized toy that can just appear from nowhere. Metal Gear. I can't tell if we're supposed to be afraid or not.
But
was everything okay? He didn't try to, like, eat you or anything? It's a teddy bear. Listen, buddy, I know what you're talking about. I know what you're trying to think of. Come on, man!
Hey, you bastard!
What the hell, fatty? You're acting like some kind of sleazy drunk dude.
Actually...
Not like there's a good kind of drunk dude. Except for Jackie Chan.
Hey!
Hey! Stop screwing around! All of you! Are you still asleep or something? We're prisoners here. We could all just die any second.
Shit.
She's right. We can't be making stupid jokes right now. We gotta do something or... A voice cut through the noise, interrupting Mondo. You're all spending an awful lot of time yelling and carrying on. Do you really think you can afford to do so? Have none of you accepted the reality of the situation?
You
mysterious anime girl. Who obviously knows the plot. Where the heck have you been? We already started the meeting without you. She didn't say a word. Instead, she just dropped a piece of paper on the table. Huh? What's this? It's a map. It appears to be a map of Hope's Peak Academy. A map? What the? Where did you find this?
Wow.
Guys, I've had a map this entire time. I just hit the tab button. It doesn't matter where I found it.
What the heck?
It does matter! You're really freaking us out right now.
But more important...
Never mind that. What's it mean?
It would seem...
Just look at it. The building we're in right now is laid out in precisely the same way as Hope's Peak Academy. So what you're saying is, this really is Hope's Peak Academy.
It's true.
Well, in terms of its construction, yes. But it looks like it's had a number of strange renovations done to it. Renovations?
However...
I don't know all the details yet. All I found was the details about the first floor. But then, this really is Hope's Peak. We didn't get kidnapped and taken to some other place? Listen, they take the best of the future elite. They make them go at each other. Whoever comes out alive, strongest ones. Battle Royale style.
So stupid it's not even possible. This is where the country's future elite are supposed to come and learn?
But if this is really is Hope's Peak, where are all the other students?
Hey, come on guys. Let's just stop talking about all this, you know, negative stuff.
But aren't you worried? Things don't look good.
Yo.
Worried? What's there to be worried about? I mean, this was all planned out, right? The people in charge of Hope's Peak put this all together, right? Man, if I got stressed every time something like this happened, I'd have ectoplasm shooting out my mouth. That's Ghostbusters.
You know?
Wrong movie.
Good things come to those who wait, right? So we just gotta chill and everything will work itself out.
Or you'll be picked off one by one. Exactly, she knows what's up.
What's your problem?
She's already planning.
But why are you laughing? What's so funny?
I'm just happy, that's all. It seems splitting up to investigate was a good idea, after all.
Haven't you been listening? Looking around was a total waste of time.
We didn't find a way out. Didn't find who's behind this. We still have no idea what's going on.
Oh.
Huh? It's not crystal clear to you what is going on.
Are you okay with this?
It is perfectly obvious that we have been imprisoned in some secret location with no way out. None of us had any response to that. We didn't want to accept the reality, but it was staring us right in the face.
You didn't have to go and say that. I was trying not to think about it. No way out. We're trapped here. What were you supposed to do?
It's very simple. If you want to leave, you just have to kill.
Stop it!
Don't even joke about that. Everyone just calm down, please. We need to stop and think about what to do from here.
Seems like...
there's gotta be something we can do. All we can do is adapt. Adapt to living our lives here from now on.
That's...
you're gonna be a murderer, aren't you? You're already plotting it. Live here? Are you saying we should just accept it?
Do you understand?
Do you understand? The lack of adaptability is a lack of survivability. Survival is not based on who is the strongest or the smartest. It comes down to who can adapt.
Actually,
as someone who has come up on the top 10 more than once, I have a suggestion.
What?
Huh? What do you mean?
Hmm.
We all understand that we are trapped here, which means we'll be spending the night. However, you all remember the rule regarding nighttime, right?
Let's see.
So regarding this nighttime, I think we need to add a rule of our own. What do you mean? Going out at nighttime should be prohibited altogether. The school regulations do not actually tell us not to go out at night. I would like to make it official.
Huh?
But why?
Are you okay with this?
The way things are now, every time night comes, we will all start to get worried and anxious.
Mm-hmm.
We will all be afraid someone might try and come kill us.
Huh?
What? If we have to worry about that night after night for who knows how long, it will wear us down in no time.
I see.
So you're suggesting we limit our activity at night, as a kind of preventive measure?
Indeed.
However, unlike the other rules, nobody can be forced to comply. We all have to agree to follow it.
What can we do?
I see what you mean, but I think I can agree to that. It's like the little goth lady has said. About something like that, we're just gonna self-destruct.
Listen to me!
On behalf of all the men here, I agree to comply.
What?
Hey, you just can't decide to speak for us.
This is fine.
So everyone is in agreement? Good. Then if you'll excuse me,
huh?
Because sharpen my knives. Huh? Wait, where are you going?
Let's
it's nighttime already.
See.
It's almost nighttime. I want to take a shower before it arrives.
I hope you are well.
So, goodbye. Moving with pure elegance, Celeste left the dining hall. Her behavior seemed so natural. I couldn't imagine anyone even trying to stop her. So, I guess it's pretty obvious where we go from here. We'll be spending the night, it looks like.
Huh.
With that ability. So, Mr. Chairman, what next? One person already left. Well then, let's say we call an end to today's meeting.
You understand?
Now go out, Justice League. Go back to your cities. Protect your people. And don't die. Like she said, it's almost nighttime anyway. We can reconvene first thing tomorrow morning.
Huh?
Do we really have to stay the night here?
What can we
Unless
do?
Unless we're already stuck. We don't have a choice. We can't go for long without getting some sleep.
Oh, this sucks.
So we just have to give up. That's all fine and good today, but what do we do tomorrow?
So in the end...
our only option is split up and look around again. Let everyone know if we find anything.
Hmm.
Yeah, okay. Let's do that. We're done for today? Good. I'm exhausted. With heavy movements, everyone head off to their private rooms. Makoto, are you ready to call it a day? Yeah, let's go. Is this really where I'll be staying for the foreseeable future? Oh, that's right. I should check the bathroom one more time before I go to bed. Only the girls' bathrooms should have locks on them, right? It is kind of weird. Alright, let's open it up. It's no use. It really is locked. Damn it, Bear! Holy crap! Jeez. Talk about an overreaction. It's like you just saw a ghost or something. Like, some kind of robot bear ghost. What are you doing here? Makoto Neki! This is super duper majorly bad. So bad, it's almost magical. Ultra magical, awful, awful attack. I'm barely tired. Can we get this over with? In point of fact, I acknowledge that the bathroom in your room has a problem with the doorframe. Wait, so the reason it won't open isn't because it's locked? The door just doesn't fit?
Hey,
Didn't you see the notice? What? Can't you read? The bathroom and the boys' rooms don't have locks. I mean, a lock in a boys' bathroom is kind of pointless, don't you think? Well, it's not that it's pointless, I guess. But I'm no expert on the birds and the bees and all that.
Listen up!
Anyway, there's a little trick to opening this particular ill-fitting door. And that's what I'm here to teach you. Okay, ready? So you just gotta turn the doorknob, then lift it up while you pull.
Yes, indeed!
Go ahead, give it a try. Turn the knob and lift the door up while I pull. When I did that, the door opened without a problem. See? It opened right up. Isn't that crazy, though? The doors are the only one that doesn't fit quite right. Are you implying I don't fit quite right with this group? You're supposed to be the ultimate lucky student, right? But it looks like you're not lucky at all.
Bye-bye!
Anyway, I definitely don't feel like being here anymore. Bye! I'm the ultimate lucky student, what? Hey, wait! Well, I did win a raffle. Damn it.
This is a school announcement. It is now 10 p.m. As such, it is officially nighttime.
Well, you're a genius.
Soon the doors to the dining hall will be locked, and entry at that point is strictly prohibited.
Take all 2 megabytes of all the RAM in your head.
Okay then. Sweet dreams, everyone. Good night. Sleep tight. Don't let the bed bugs bite.
Why does Robo Bear need to drink wine anyway? Looks like it's nighttime. We all promised we wouldn't leave our rooms now. All I can do now is try to get some sleep. While still mumbling to myself, I collapsed into the bed. My eyes closed almost immediately. It's not that I was ready for bed, exactly. I was just utterly exhausted. I told you I was very tired. I was as if I spent an entire day staring at TV watching movies, or reading a visual novel for an hour, or like some kind of illusion where I'd been tossed into a made-up fantastical world. Yeah, that feels about right. There's no easy way to just accept the situation we've suddenly been dropped into. This is how the curtain closed on my first day to Hope's Peak Academy. Soon enough, I was asleep. Would it be too much to hope that when I woke up, I'd realize it was all a dream? I hate that feeling, like really bad. It's kind of lame as far as endings go, but I'd be fine with that. Actually, that'd be the best. Oh, Nakoma Feeder! Boy, this reminds me of Baguka. In any normal school, Mr. Monokuma would be a kind teacher. But when I think about what's coming up, I'm just so full of pride and joy. Our ceremony earlier today was absolutely splendid. Thank you all very much. Remember that you're all students of Hope's Peak Academy, and strive to refine your ideals.
I swear to you, I will send you all off into a new tomorrow!
Ding dong, bing bong. Witch is dead.
Good morning, everyone! It is now 7 a.m. and nighttime is officially over. Time to rise and shine.
I don't want to wake up, Mr. Evil Teddy Bear.
Get ready to greet another beautiful day.
Apparently it's morning, but thanks to the total lack of windows, there's no way to know for sure. Anyway, what should I do now? Maybe I should go find Sayaka, and we can figure out where to go from here together. She did say she's my assistant now. Okay, it's decided. I'm gonna head to her room. With a newfound determination, I left my room. Alright, so we gotta go with Sayaka. I'm gonna see what you're up to real quick, though. Good morning. Yes, morning greetings are quite a delight. That's an energizing way to start the day. Now then, let's make sure we both do our very best throughout the day. Sure. I wonder if he's always like this. Okay, let's just go to the one character's room then, which is right next to mine, actually. Ding dong. Hello? Good morning, Sayaka. Huh?
Listen.
A favor? I was just getting ready to head out. If it's okay, would you like to come with me? Maybe we could talk. Yeah, sure. Where are you headed? I've been thinking that there might be something around here I could use for self-defense. Self-defense? Well, I mean, whoever is keeping us here could show up and attack us anytime. You never know. Whoever trapped us here. Whoever presented us with rules for murdering each other. Whoever put us in this insane position. She's right. You never know when they might attack. So I just want to be able to protect myself no matter what happens. A weapon to protect herself. A weapon to surpass. Something something gear. Well, now that I think about it, that display case in the gym entryway had a bunch of stuff. Maybe. Oh, the gym? Okay, let's go. Again.
Like I said, I'm psychic.
You just have that one line recorded and they just play it every time they get a chance. Come on, I'm just kidding. Seriously, I just have amazing intuition. Am I really so easy to predict? Anyway, we should head to the gym. Wow, we can teleport! Let's teleport into a wall! Oh, hello there.
Hey,
That's kind of funny how the sprites move. It reminds me of old PC games like the Goosebumps, the mutant one. Oh, there's some other characters around now.
I hope you are well.
Okay.
Our day is awful. How's yours?
Is that okay?
You scare me. You goth lolly.
Hey,
Anyone else hanging around the halls anymore? No. Let's walk manually to the place. I'll poke around some other places real quick, see if anyone else is hanging around.
Hey,
Ah, you can see where everyone's hanging out. So, there's people in the dining hall right now. These people are on the main floor. He's in the laundry room. And here's the first floor. So they're in the hallways. School store. Main hall. And the gym is where we gotta go. So let's go to the main hall real quick. I haven't been in here yet, so I just wanted to check it out while I'm here. Monokuma things.
Hi.
Yes, it is a date. Exactly. You see the setup. Look, she's basically not denying it. Kinda. Yeah. You play detective. Look for clues, and you know where.
Sorry!
they make a good couple. Yes. Jim. I don't care about you characters as much. There's a sword over there. Folded over 1,000 times. Here we go. We might be able to find something here to protect myself with. Yeah, I'm sure I'll find something in the display case I can use. Hold it over 1,000 times. Is this a sword? Oh no, I think it's just a replica. Still, it's pretty impressive. It's completely covered in gold coating, but... Jeez, I barely touched and I got that gold stuff all over my hands. What a cheap knocko. Wow, you're right. Your hands are totally gold. Even just for self-defense, I think it's a little... Well, it's still better than nothing, I guess.
Hey,
You should take it with you. It might help liven up your room a little. You think so? But I guess you better be careful taking it back. You should wrap it in newspaper or something. And just like that, it's been decided. I don't see anything I could really use for self-defense. Hey, don't worry about it. It's not like you need it right away, right? Plus, if anything were to happen, when the time comes, I'll protect you.
Huh?
You will protect me? I'm not gonna be able to keep that promise. But I'm just trying to woo you. I'm smooth without realizing it. Thank you for saying that. My normalness is my charm. If I've got you on my side, I guess I don't need a weapon after all. Sayaka giggled as she said that. That mysterious smile. I can tell it comes from the heart. It makes me feel at ease. When I look at her, I honestly feel like I can do anything. Okay, we can stop looking for a weapon then. But as long as we're here, let's hang out a bit more. This is awkward. I know I said I wanted to talk to you, but now that we're here, I don't really know what to talk about.
Sorry.
And I was the one who invited you to come with me, too, so sorry. It's okay. I mean, if there's nothing to talk about, then we can just not talk. Come on, man. You're smoother than that. Huh? You don't have to force yourself to talk. We can just... I don't know, stare off into space or whatever? Stare off into space? Oh, but you're probably just super bored. Just standing around doing nothing. No, it's not as boring, it's just... I've never really done it before. I don't have a lot of time to just do nothing. Well, that's good, it means you're busy. That's a positive. I guess that makes sense. You're not a normal high school student like me. You've got tons of stuff to do every day.
Listen.
Hey, this is kind of out of nowhere, but... Makoto, do you have a dream? Well, what about you, Sayaka? My dream is to be normal. Ultimate normal. What's your dream? I'd love to hear. My dream is... I've always wanted to be a star, as long as I can remember. You mean a literal star, don't you? I grew up without a mother, you know. And my dad worked really late every night. I was always home alone. I was just a kid, you know? So I was really lonely. But that all changed when I saw a pop star on TV for the first time. She was so pretty. Like a princess. And she could sing and dance. But more than anything else, there was her smile. Looking at her smile, I could feel my loneliness melting away. You really bought into that idol magic, didn't you? I decided that's what I want to be someday. I wanted to give that kind of encouragement to others. Eventually, that became my dream. That's so amazing, though. You're able to actually fulfill your lifelong dream. Honestly, it's really incredible. I did whatever it took to reach that dream. I mean it. Even some things that... weren't so pleasant. Huh?
I honestly...
Those are those dead eyes. That's scary. I honestly believe that as long as you kept chasing your dreams, someday they had to come true. But to do that, you can't take your eyes off of your dream. Not even for a second. Even if sometimes it's a bad dream, whether you're awake, whether you're asleep, to make your dream a reality, you have to keep your gaze fixed on no matter what. In that world, if you lose focus for even a split second, you get left behind. This is like really real. You have to keep on swimming against the current, without even taking time to breathe. That's the kind of world my dream lives in. Being an idol is scary and depressing. Is it really that tough? Is it not fun at all?
Oh no!
Oh, don't get the wrong idea. It's super fun.
What?
But that's exactly what scares me. Huh? I enjoy every single day I wake up and get to do what I do. Everyone in our group is amazing. We're rivals in a way, but they all mean so much to me. We've all been performing together since we're young. They're all like a family to me. Without them, I would have given up my dream a long time ago. To work together and fulfill our dreams together has brought me so much happiness.
But that's why...
But that's the thing that scares me the most. Are you scared that if you lose that happiness, you're gonna be empty inside? Exactly. If the world gets tired of us, then what happens? You stop being an idol, and you take what money you can and put it into proper savings accounts. What happens to us? Then the dream dies. Those wonderful days come to an end. And everyone goes their separate ways. You keep each other's phone numbers and keep in contact. Sayaka. She's trembling. She must be terrified. She worked so hard, sacrificed so much to get where she is. She must be terrified of losing it. So that's the reason I decided to come to Hope's Peak. Huh? What do you mean? Well, they say that if you graduate from here, success is basically guaranteed. Which means if I could keep on performing with my best friends, forever and ever. Nothing's forever, darling. At least, that's what I thought. I really did believe that, but... Now we're trapped here, with no way out. They're probably waiting for me. While I'm in here, the world out there is forgetting about me. Ooh boy, that's even deader eyes, times two. Minute by minute, we're all disappearing. But still... Sayaka?
Why?
I can't afford to be stuck in here. That was the first time I heard her cry out from deep within herself. She sounds... desperate. But I can understand why she'd feel that way. Trapped here this way, the dream she put so much effort into and is on the verge of disappearing forever. That isn't something that can be fixed with a few kind words. The weight she's carrying. I can't even imagine it.
Sorry.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to complain. I kinda killed the mood, huh? No, not at all.
Sorry.
I'm really sorry. Sayaka? Actually, are you hungry? You know, like whenever you have like a tragic backstory drop and you start flipping out and, you know, I'm very awkward, the best thing to solve is just some food. Before we head back, why don't we go to the dining hall and get some food? So...
Okay.
You want me to make us something to eat? I might not look like it, but I'm actually a pretty good cook. Boy, you cheered up fast. Wow, really? What's your specialty? Chili oil. You mean the condiment? Just kidding. She burst out laughing. Her earlier mood disappeared, replaced by the bright smile I'd quickly grown used to. But how'd it happen so fast? It was almost like a mask, like some kind of neutral expression. I'm the only normal person here. Anyway, we headed to the dining hall to get something to eat before returning to our rooms. The only thing in my room is a fake sword covered in gold. All it does is make me feel that much more uncomfortable. Anyway, there's still plenty of time left in the day. I really don't feel like just sitting here. Maybe I'll take a look around. I guess this is when the dating sim element comes into. Would you like to know more? Keep in your friendships. Give them presents. What happens if they die? Then it just like ends there. New skills, which can prove useful as everything plays out. Time will pass, so we only get so many. Okay. I guess I'll save before I go like choosing people to talk to and grinding their social points.